So summary of results and putting it all together. If y is equal to x squared, we've seen that dy dx, the gradient, is 2x. If y is equal to x cubed, we've seen that the gradient dy dx will be 3x squared. So to differentiate the power of x, 1, multiply by the original power. So for x squared, we multiply by 2 to give us 2x. That's 2x. And for x cubed, we multiplied x by 3 to give us 3x. So you multiply by the power. And then secondly, you reduce that power by 1. So x cubed, 3 was reduced to 2. 3 to 2. So, in summary, to differentiate, multiply by the original power and reduce that power by 1. That will be obvious in the next example. So here we are differentiating y is equal to x to the power 4. So on getting dy dx, 4 comes forward, giving us 4x, and reduce the power 4 to 3. And b, y is equal to x to power 5. So on differentiation, 5 comes forward and reduce the power to 4. See, we have y is equal to x to power 6. On differentiation, dy dx will be 6 comes forward and the power is now 5. There we have y is equal to kx squared. So 2 on differentiation will come forward as 2kx to power 1, which is x. So y is equal to x on differentiation. That's actually x to power 1. So on differentiation, it will be 1x to power 0. And that's 1. X to power 0 is 1. In f, we're differentiating y is equal to 8. Remember, 8 can be written as 8x to power 0, which is 1 in that sense. So dy dx will be 0 comes forward times 8 x to the power 0 minus 1. So since we are multiplying by 0, the answer is 0. Therefore, this is a very important result whereby if you differentiate a constant like 8 in that case, the answer is always 0. It's a very important result. So in G, we have y is equal to 12x to the power n. So on differentiation, n comes forward giving us 12 n x to power n minus 1.